back to you, Sugar Bear and Gracie.
Bob's lived in the Antelope Valley for 30 years and comes out of Quartz Hill Hills. Out of the Quartz Hill Hills for this parade every year.
And I wasn't going to touch that one. That one had your name all over it, Mike.
Well, thank you so much for that. You
know. Right behind Bob is the Jacobson family representing A.V. Street.
Rodgers. The biggest American Flyer wagon I've ever seen.
Jim Jacobson is in his 48 GMC pickup. He needed it for this big red wagon to pull all his grandkids. Happy holidays, Jim. Ooh, listen
now,
to that.
Now.
I like that American Flyer. That's a nice size.
Yeah, I wonder where they got that. It says Prototype 1 or something.
It's got a license plate on it. That's a big one.
This is an interesting entry here. This is the Lancaster Elementary School Band. What this is the Lancaster School District Combined Band. These kids are all under the age of 12. And they're from all of the different elementary schools in the Lancaster School District. There is no other band like this anywhere in Southern California.
And you know what? For their age, they sound really great.
Yeah. They're
really
having
great.
A great time.
That's a nice age to play, isn't it?
It is.
Dr. Ted Warner, he's a familiar face in our holiday parade, driving his white 1934 Mercedes convertible.
What happened? Where's your tin Lizzie? He usually drives his little putt-putt car.
Right.
Boy, he's graduated.
That is a nice car.
He's Dr. Ted Warner's a band director. He plays music. He's been practicing in this valley for a number of years, and he's got a dance band and very active senior. He's a good guy.
Always comes out and shows his support during the holiday parade.
We were getting briefed yesterday. They were saying, and Dr. Ted Warner, you all know him.
And we do.
He's a legend. Boy, now here comes some balloons.
Balloons.
Serious balloons.
Who do you think blew all those up?
This is the judge's trophy from Desert Christian School.
This boat is entitled A World United and features the St. Jude logo in the center of the star.
By the way, I'm supposed to mention, and I really should, all the banner holders today are from Desert Christian School. So they found youngsters who were willing to carry the banners down the street announcing these winners.
Very good. That's gorgeous.
It is. And I do wonder who blew up all those balloons. They're all full of helium. That's a big job.
To say thank you to St. Jude, too, for all the work they put in on this float.
Big truck.
Their sign says, Compassionate Care for All Ages. St. Jude Home Health Care, the Judge's Trophy.
Dealers here in the valley. They all have chipped in and allowed the parade entries and the parade participants to use some gorgeous cars. So we want to take our hats off if we had any on, but we want to say a good thank you to all the car dealers. When you see these gorgeous new cars, they didn't just come out of thin air. They came out of showrooms here in the valley. So that's kind of cool.
Also, we'll hear Cole Middle School in just a moment. We also need to mention that right after the parade, be sure to go to the Antelope Valley High School and attend the halftime show competition. That's high schools from all around the Southland competing in an event the whole family will enjoy, and proceeds from it might go to the Antelope Valley High School Band. And the parade ends up right there, so you might as well just follow the last entrance, which is probably Santa, go on down and listen to the competition.
Which is kind of neat, because that's one of the reasons why a lot of bands participate in our parades up here in the valley, because they have these competitions, and they're on a point circuit. So they have to win a certain amount of points to actually get the awards and the trophies and stuff that they're all competing for. So we get the opportunity to hear some really good music.
That's right. Here's the Cole Middle School Pep Squad. They're under the direction of Adrian Holmes, and the choreography you see there from the Pep Squad is by Rebecca Beltran.
So that's Pep? They have a lot of Pep, do they?
Pep.
Have this this music and this rhythm and this beat in their head. They can hear it. We don't hear it, but they're hearing a specific.
Now, do you know what their mascot is? They've got bears on their sweatshirts there.
I don't know. Maybe it is a bear. I bet we'll find out. And again, maybe not. Also, as long as we're thanking people, you notice a lot of fire trucks today?
And a lot of flashing lights. Yes, I have.
A lot of the fire departments here in the valley have contributed vehicles for these kids to ride on. I have a feeling that maybe one of these fire trucks is going to blow his horn, so stand by for that.
And these are from Air Force Plant 42.
One of the largest, and I think one of the only shared contractor and Air Force base plants in the whole country.
Can you tell us about this big yellow thing, Mike?
Well, yes. This is a Helms bakery truck. No, actually, this is Air Force Plant 42's fire truck, specifically designed to put out aircraft fires. It's a foam truck. It's also a water truck, and it's four-wheel drive, and it's real big.
Looks like it did the job, doesn't it?
Here's Congressman Howard Buck McKeon. Familiar face here in the valley. It's always an honor to have a congressman with us. He's here today with his wife and his kids, his grandchildren. And a colorful red Christmas shirt by George.
Always a pleasure to have Congressman McKeon join us for the parade.
I said his grandkids were there. I didn't see them.
Well, these aren't them. This is the Parkview Intermediate School Band.
He's got a lot of grandkids. Parkview is one of the first intermediate schools or elementary schools in Lancaster. It's been at the same place there on Avenue J for about 30 years. So I'm told. That's what
I
my
imagine
notes
you've
show.
Seen a lot of schools crop up too over the years, haven't you, Mike?
Why, yes, I remember when there was only 9 schools in the whole Southwest area.
Actually, we've been doing this parade for a few years. They're going to build a library here right across the street from us. Right now we can sit here and look at the Catholic Church and the Catholics.
And we can also look at Boy Scouts Pack 67.
We can't. You folks can't, but we can. Totally irrelevant.
Riding
Let's talk about bicycles. All those little bikes. Have you ever ridden a bike like that?
Little bitty bike?
Those little mountain bikes.
I have a mountain bike, as a matter of fact.
Here are the
Girl
Scouts.
Right around the neighborhood.
Now there's.
That's it.
This is a joint effort by several of the Girl Scout troops here in the valley. And the truck was donated by Antelope Valley Building Materials, and it was decorated with handmade decorations. They were all made by the kids.
Shows us a holiday jubilee at home, and these Girl Scout troops were from East Lancaster.
Now, see, this is the way to be in a parade.
Yeah, that's great.
You get on a truck, and you ride down the parade route.
Do that Miss America wave.
Yeah. What an elbow, wrist, I don't know.
Something like that. Here's some noise. I know that sound. That's Harley Davidson. Several of them, as a matter of fact.
They are, as we understand, connected with 93.5 Classic Rock FM here in the valley. Yeah, there comes their, I think it's a 58 Cadillac.
This is KLKX Miss Heartbreaker Sherry Williams. She's riding in the lead sled.
The lead sled?
The lead sled. This car will be given away by Classic 93.5 later in December. And of course, the lead sled was escorted, as you saw, by those Harley riders from High Desert Cycle in Lancaster. And they want to say happy holidays to everyone from Classic 93.5 and High Desert Cycle.
The last American-made motorcycle, I think.
Don't you love the sound of Harleys?
For about 30, 40 seconds. Yeah, they're a lot of fun.
Have you ever driven one?
No. No, I haven't.
I had a Honda 70 when I was a kid. Does that count?
I had a Honda step through my own self. It was bad, though, I'm telling you.
It is if you're a 10-year-old kid.
Here's the Palmdale Veterans Color Guard. This color guard represents veterans organizations in the Palmdale area. coming up next is Sue and Al. Of course, Sue and Al Kirky in a 1930 Model A. I could say...
What do we want to call him? He has so many hats.
I could say who he is and what he does, but it would take all day.
He's a president of Antelope Valley College and president of the Antelope Valley Board of Trade, just to name a few things. He's an author, has a book published, and does just about everything else here in the Antelope Valley as well.
Great community leader.
That's right.
Okay. Here comes some Corvettes. This is one of my favorite entries in these parades, is the Corvette Club here in the Valley. And they have been invaded by Antelope Valley College marauders, I think. Yes, the Antelope Valley College cheerleaders are hitching a ride today on the Corvette.
This 15-member squad took away two first-place trophies at the National Cheerleading Association this summer. They're graduates from eight different schools and have combined their spirit and enthusiasm to cheer on the college marauder athletic teams. Of course, they want you to all come out and see the men's and women's basketball teams this season. Have you heard how they're going to be?
They're actually both of the men's and the women's are doing rather well in the early stages. They're winning some basketball games. That's a great thing to go see because it's inside. It's nice and warm when it's in the wintertime, and there's a lot of spirit, and it makes me tired watching those kids run up and down the court. Back and forth, but they have a great time.
I'm tired watching the cheerleaders do a cartwheel.
All kinds of different Corvettes. I wish I could tell you the different years, but they're all gorgeous cars.
All decorated festively with Christmas and holiday decorations, trees.
And cheerleaders. Cheerleaders, decorations, and trees.
Can't beat it. That one's got some snow on it.
Yeah, that's...
Where do you get that snow?
Now, those are 68, aren't they? A 68 and 69?
I couldn't tell you.
I couldn't either. I don't...
I just couldn't tell you. They're cool. That's all I can tell you.
And there's a lot of them. Every year, there seems like there's about two or three more members in the club.
You know, Mike, I know you've announced these parades many times, but have you ever been an entrant in a parade, marched in it, or ridden in it, or done anything in the parade?
As a matter of fact,
yes.
Some of us with twisted senses of reality were involved in a parade float in the fair parade just this last year.
That's right. I announced that parade. I remember. We'll talk about that in a second, but here's the exotic feline breeding compound and Save on Fence Company.
Ooh, they brought a tiger today.
And that is Jasmine, a two-year-old female Bengal tiger. She lives with 60 of her endangered feline friends in Rosamond. And the public is invited to visit the facility any day except Wednesday for free tours and to help save our rare and endangered large cat. She's beautiful.
My wife, Sherry, and... my little boy Zachary go out there all the time. They go out there about twice a month, and every time they go out there, they keep adding things. So if you haven't haven't been there for a while,
it's very impressive.
It's fascinating. It really is. There's a bunch of these exotic felines right now in the middle of the desert, and they're really making their habitat look good. Boy, look at
when you drive out there, you think you're going nowhere, don't you?
Yeah.
Like there couldn't possibly be anything out there, but then just a great facility. Like you say, it just keeps adding more and more all the time. More and more cats and more of the big areas they live in.
Here's the Roadrunners 4-H Club. Holiday Jubilee in the country. The Quartzsill Club is celebrating this season by providing food for needy families. The club teaches the importance of community while having fun with all their different 4-H projects. They got a little picnic goat on there, if you saw that.
That's just a down on the farm Holiday Jubilee, isn't
it? Yes, sir, I like it.
Your supervisor, Michael Antonovich, longtime supervisor representing this area. He and his staff wish everyone a great holiday.
In an Oldsmobile 442. We don't know who's riding with him. We say hello to all of them. Here's the Paiute Intermediate School Band.
Leading the Warriors is drum major Kelsey Lee, and they're directed by Jeanette Crown. Color guard and drill team captains are Monica Ortega, Katie Jacobs, Tracy Cagley, Elise Webb, Jennifer Lane, and Michelle Brown.
Intermediate school is like junior high. Cub Scouts, I think.
More Scouts. Can't be a parade without Scouts.
Pack 691 and 694, so the sign says. Once again, this is the way to go through through a parade. Get on a truck and ride down the street.
And they're a verbal little group, aren't they?
Well, it's the night before Christmas. And all through the wagon. Not a kid that's quiet, and I ain't bragging.
Here's the Desert View School Just Say No Club. Riding on this float are the winners of the Just Say No poster contest, which was recently held at Desert View School. Good project, Just Say No.
The Antelope Valley Fair Miss Rodeo Queen. Let's see if we can get them all in here. Brandy DeJohn, or DeYoung, it's pronounced. Junior and Junior Miss Brianna Spaulding, I'm way behind. Little Miss Brooke Tomlinson. We're sorry, folks, we don't get some of your names in, but you're there. You know who you are. There's a lot of there's rodeo queens and Junior Miss Rodeo Queens and youth queens. There's so many queens.
And there's Alfie. And along with Alfie is the Antelope Valley Fair Board of Directors, President Randy Jakeway, Vice President Rita Burleson. Merry Christmas. Directors Joanne Gilley, Jim Lott, Forrest McElroy, Rob Harris, Jack Cephas, Ralph Bazigian, and Betty Smith. And of course, manager Dan Jacobs. They're all riding in a decorated trolley car.
Are they mad? Still mad about you trying to sneak into the fair last year?
It was just that one time.
Oh, yeah. Here's the Antelope Valley College Marauder Band. And these folks are really good. They're under the direction of Jim Reddish. And we've seen them out at the ball field during football games, and let's listen to them play one. Drum major is Chris Black, assistant drum major is Milton Doucette III. Jim Reddish is a good bass player, but if you notice today, he was right in the middle, he was playing the trombone.
And there's Wendy Ray Connell, Miss Antelope Valley. She'll remember, Mike, we had Wendy Ray on our talk show around town a few months ago, right after she was crowned Antelope Valley Queen, and she's just a delight.
Yes,
charming young lady.
And she's busy. I wonder if they tell these kids how busy they're going to be when that's the day.
Along with her was Junior Miss Stephanie Perry and little Miss Antelope Valley, Lauren Moniz. The Challenger Middle School Band. Drum major Darren Dyke heads the Marching Wildcats and under the direction of David McClaslin.
Again, this is a junior high school. These kids are young and they're really playing good. Well, they're beating their drums good.
Hopefully they'll play a song for us. There we go. Thank you.
land who supports the Shrine Crippled Children's Hospital. It's a really, really neat cause.
Wouldn't be a parade without Shriners, now would it?
That's right. If you have a crippled child or someone in need, call a Shriner. President Russell Fouch, I believe you pronounced that, and Lee Fogle is the captain.
Right behind them are the familiar AV Shrine Cart. These vehicles each fly the American flag, symbol of the freedom we all enjoy, and each driver is wearing a Shrine Fez, symbolic of the Shrine Crippled Children's Hospital, one of the world's great charities, and they're going to give us a show, Mike.
Yeah, and I'm glad I'm sitting up high and off on the curb.
Gave us a salute, and there they go.
One of those Shriners is George Root, a well-known community leader, and it's a very scary thing to think that he's driving one of those things free and unfettered down Lancaster Boulevard. There he goes.
They're having a ball. I don't think I'd want to be the cameraman down there. I'm not sure. They know what they're doing, though.
Dallas is our ground camera person. He is always in harm's way.
I'd be in full armor if I was down there.
As these big trucks, you know, these big flatbed trucks go by, they have the floats on. Watch how close the wheels come to his feet. Oh, maybe we better not say that.
Let's not let him know.
Yeah, we better not let him know. Speaking of which, next up is the President's Trophy.
Sports Radio 610 and Hot 97.
Radio 610, all sports, all the time.
And they're cooking up Christmas Jubilee. As you can see, there's Santa's workshop in the back, a lot of little elves.
Another big, big truck. Now, wait a minute now.
We were mistaken. This is the New Vista Elementary School Choir. And they won the President's Award. The 1995 New Vista Honor Choir presents, as I said, cooking up a Christmas Jubilee. This is their theme for their Christmas musical, which is coming up on December 14th, so about a couple weeks away.
So far, they have the trophy for most number of people in a single entry. There's over 150 kids there.
150 elves and 10 soldiers.
I don't know what happened with the banner in front, but we'll figure all
that
out later.
We'll find it. They're coming up later.
Now, this is the Queen's Trophy, I hope. I'm pretty sure it is.
These are the Weevilos and the Wolf Cubs. Pack 68 and their family.
They decorated this float themselves. It took them a long time to do it. And most of the facilities were donated by Terry Lumber and the nice guys over there that sell you all your building and construction and lumber needs.
It's a nice float. And here's the Foothills Intermediate School Band. A lot of intermediate school bands and middle school bands.
Now those are some sharp uniforms, and this is a sharp band. And they have bagpipes.
Those are gorgeous costumes, aren't they?
They
uniforms,
really are.
I should say.
Usually when you find gorgeous costumes like that, you find a band booster club.
I was going to say, there's some support here behind this group. This is a sharp-looking group. I love the drum majors and majorettes.
Yeah.
They're so regal.
Tell you more about this school, but we can't, except that they have a great, beautiful organization.
Well, there's a competition for the uniforms. This group is score mighty high. I got that to say about them.
And there is.
Do they judge on that too?
Yeah, there's points for visual.
Is that the Irish jig they're doing?
Scottish.
Scottish.
It's a bit of Scottish.
Oh, all right.
Next up is what my son calls a Homer.
Looks like the one you drive around town, doesn't it?
It's a motorhome.
This is the Visiting Nurse Association, their caravan. It's a mobile health clinic. established as an Antelope Valley Community Cooperative Project to provide health services to the outlying areas here in the valley, to children and adults regardless of their ability to pay.
United Way donations made possible the purchase of this coach. They operate the service with the High Desert Hospital and also with local school districts. If you look closely, you'll see those. You'll see that van around around the different schools for vaccinations and for well baby clinics and stuff like that. It is. It's a great service.
And this is Miss Agua Dulce, Queens, 1995. Here in the first car is Miss Agua Dulce.
Now wait a minute. These are the junior queens. The junior Miss Agua. Miss Agua Dulce couldn't be here. She called just earlier this morning before you got here.
Oh,
yeah,
all
she
right.
called
I
in.
Didn't get that message.
Said she couldn't get here. She was got hung up on the freeway or something. But anyway, this is Junior Miss Agua Dulce and the Princesses for 95. And I have their names here somewhere, but I can't get to them fast enough. But anyway, congratulations. Here's Judge Richard Spann. We know him. He's not in a beauty contest, but he's in a judicial contest, and he's won once. And
yes,
I guess
he has.
Just understand that he is going into a re-election campaign here soon. So good luck to him.
And right behind the judge is KLOA Thunder Country Radio. This is a new country radio station for the Antelope Valley. It's located at 104.9 on your radio dial. They're country and they're proud.
Yeah.
Can't have too many country radio stations.
Absolutely. Absolutely. They're out of Ridgecrest, I believe. A long way.
This is the Tops Club. Tops means take off town sensibly. Good thing for this time of the year, isn't it?
Well, maybe for the first of the year.
This is their entry for the parade, and they wish everyone a happy holiday. Henry Ficklin is their chapter king and area king. He lost 51 pounds.
Wow. Sarah Gutierrez, chapter queen. Area queen, state queen, and most improved.
And she lost 148 pounds. Can you believe that?
No.
Wow, it must work.
Yeah.
I'll be calling him about January 1st.
Hello. Would this be yet another?
It would be.
Intermediate school. From Santa Paula. These kids drove a long way to get down here, and I bet they left in the middle of the night. And we are proud to have them in our parade. Welcome to you. We don't know who some of the members are and the directors, but
this is the Isabel Intermediate School Band.
All right, we're going to take a short commercial break here, and then we will be back with more of the Lancaster Holiday Parade, so don't you dare touch that dial.
Stay with us.
Hi, Phil. I was at the Antelope Valley Mall just picking up a few things for the wish list. Tonight, how was the usual holiday fair? Sylvia, you should see Jim. He's been climbing around the house all day hanging up the holiday lights. Yeah, we're still expecting you around 7. No, don't bring a thing. Candles might be a nice touch.
For family fashion and holiday fun, it's the Antelope Valley Mall.
So you finally did it. You got yourself one of those spiffy new satellite dishes. You broke the bank for the dish, the installation, and the monthly programming fee, but hey, you got a lot of channels. Unfortunately, not one of them carries the local news, so you didn't get the story about the transit strike. And you obviously didn't get the local forecast, but you did get all those channels.
The Great Frame-Up in Lancaster is all wrapped up and ready for great holiday wishes. No matter what you like on your walls, if you want a frame around it, come and see us. We specialize in unique multimedia poster, shadow box, and memorabilia art and framing. Plus, there's a great gallery right on the premises. With our special computer-driven matte cutting system and our friendly professional staff, holiday gift giving is, well, it's a breeze. No matter what you like, you'll love the Great Frame-Up on 20th Street West and Avenue J in Lancaster.
And this is Richie.
Very cute.
Our vacation last summer.
Memories that you share.
My husband.
Mm-hmm.
Or memories that last the longest. Bring your favorite color snapshots to Kinko's.
and we'll turn them into a full-color calendar.
Oh, sweet.
A perfect gift for the people you want to share your memories with.
It's so pretty.
Just make sure they're everyone's favorite memories.
Oh, my.
Welcome back to the 1995 Holiday Parade here in downtown Lancaster. We're looking right now at Kelly Theater performing art.
Now, what's that song?
Run, run, Rudolph.
My kind of Christmas song. What do you think? Pretty sassy.
Miss Chuck Berry.
This is an award-winning studio of all major competitions. They offer classes in ballet, tap, jazz, acrobatics, and they start from beginning levels to advanced levels. And you know what? I've been talking about taking tap dancing lessons several years now. Now, you know about that I want to learn how to tap dance. So
no.
Now I know where to go.
Really?
Yeah. You didn't know that?
No, I didn't.
I haven't told you that.
Tap
I've
dance?
Always wanted to know how to tap dance. I've got a great linoleum kitchen floor I can practice on. Just tap away.
There's Miss Lancaster. Monica Barnes. Truck. In a brand new Mustang GT convertible.
You love those Mustangs, the
I
new
do.
Ones, don't
they're
you?
Cool.
You want one. You want a yellow one or a red one?
Red one.
Couldn't remember.
And here is the Lancaster City Council. Well, let's say most of the Lancaster City Council. Mayor George Runner, Vice Mayor Michael Singer. Come on. Michael Singer, Reverend Henry Hearns, Frank Roberts, and their family. I said most of the city council.
And they're wishing everyone the very best of everything this holiday season.
I'll tell you why. Because Deborah Shelton has her own car. She has her own antique Continental that she rides in the parade. Not that she doesn't like the rest of the council, it's just she has her own private confidence.
Well, when you have a car like that, you might as well ride by yourself.
And you ride in it with your family. And
her little boy and girl, it looks like. And right behind Councilwoman Shelton is Rosamond American Legion Color Guard.
Guarding the color. And there's a drill team coming up right behind them, also from Rosamond.
This is made up of the American Legion Post Auxiliary members and Sons of the American Legion.
Rosamond, our sister city to the north. I think it's there in the world, supposedly, it's up there.
I believe it.
You think?
Yes, I believe it. This is the Rosamond High School Band. The runners are under the direction of Michael Chang and are led by drum major Brian Daniel and color guard captain Belinda Fisher. Of course, all our bands today have chosen, appropriately enough, Christmas songs.
Yes, it works so well.
Doesn't it work out nicely?
Christmas and holiday
parade. They put some
thought
into that. Let's listen.
Every now and then we have a motorcycle coming, zooming up to our table with updates on the parade. And I think they're having a good time.
Hey, they're still in their pajamas. How'd they get by with that? And that's a mayor, too.
Rosamond Honorary Mayor.
That's Jeannie Maynard.
And of course, Jeannie's from the exotic feline compound. She ought to be Honorary Mayor.
She deserves it. That's the Rosamond Chamber President, Dr. Jane Leonard.
No, I don't know what year that car is.
I wasn't even going to ask.
Antelope Valley four-wheelers. Antelope Valley four-wheelers enjoy the outdoors, and they invite everybody to discover that kind of fun if you're into it. Get a hold of the four-wheeler club and
out and play in the dirt with them.
You're a family of four-wheelers. You've got two in the family now, right?
Yeah.
Never
been off the road.
Well, the four-wheel.
Yes. Never been off the road.
Oh, okay, fine. Yeah, that we're going to do that one of these days, but...
Would you both take your... You've got Jeeps. What kind of Jeeps are they?
Wrangler. Sherry would never take hers off the road.
Then you'd have to wash it.
Yeah, it'll get dirty. Now I see some...
This is Dance Magic. Dance Studio is owned by Vicky Zarley and Bonnie Pardue. They teach ballet, tap, jazz, and hip-hop to children 3 years of age and older. They've been established since 1981 and have participated in the Lancaster Christmas Parade since 1982.
That's another place
for me to take tap dancing
lessons. I really think you should do that. Oh, man. Okay, we had a whole truck full of their students, and now here comes another.
They're just bop, bop, bopping through the holidays.
Yeah, I think they may have broken the record for number of people in one entry.
Sort of have a little 50s theme there going. Their jeans rolled up, and their ponytails, bobby socks. I think that's the moms there at the back. What do you think? Some pretty cool bop, bop, and hip-hop moms.
Come on. Good News Bears serving Jesus.
Lancaster,
I am sorry
Forest
for that faux bow.
We'll get you some more coffee. It's okay.
I don't know what's wrong with this. It's too nice out. You see,
I'm
all geared up for it being cold, and I'm relaxing here. Good News Bears.
A very berry
Christmas,
what they're saying. They have a manger scene on their float.
Once again, reminding us all that Jesus is the reason.
For the season.
Oh, they're singing, too. That took some work to put that little float together.
Go ahead.
Well, let me see. It's a Desert High School band.
They're directed by Ken Link and led by drum major Jason Heidenreich, and they are the Scorpions.
It looks like they're down there getting some reed update.
Some reed update?
Reed update. Now that their reed supervisor is replacing reeds. I can see from back there. You know, every good band's got to have a reed supervisor.
You bet. About halfway through.
Yeah.
You need that reed
like
update.
A pit stop kind of thing. I was going to say pit stop, but that has a whole other connotation.
Then we'd have to take a commercial break if we thought about that too long.
Yeah, I suppose. But actually, they're setting up their reeds, and now they're all set to go.
Is that called the roll-off, the round-off? You know, when you hear that, duff-duff, that all the bands do? What is that called? You're a music guy.
That's a roll-off.
Is it a roll-off? Round-up, what's that?
That's what they have in Texas.
Cattle thing. I'm getting confused. Scorpion Marching Band from Edwards Air Force Base, the Desert High School.
They are under the direction of Ken Link, and the drum major is Jason Heinrich. They are the Scorpions.
Her thoroughbred mare, and Julie Kincaid was riding her quarter arrayed Arab mare.
And there is Mary Ellen Harder.
Cattle company showing their red, white, and blue colors. Great hamburgers.
Yep.
If you want a great hamburger, go to the Texas Cattle Company.
And they're huge. They are gigantic.
They're normal size. They're about right.
And right behind them, KUTY, Fiesta Latina, AM 1470.
Along with the American Dental Center, they've created Show Us Your Christmas Smile. Riding on their float are KUTY Air personalities, Pepe Delgado, Carlos Ortiz, and Miguel Orlano, along with Miss Fiesta Latina.
Looks very comfortable and serene. And
good. Very cleanly.
Yes, quite. Now, I heard about this next entry here.
The Lancaster Skating Rink?
Yeah, they said they were going to have a bunch of rollerblades.
And Hockey Plus also, we should say.
And that's exactly what they've done.
They're located at 44743 Yucca Avenue, just one block south of us here on Lancaster Boulevard. I want everybody to come out and check out the exciting sport of roller hockey. You ever been on those inline skates, they're called?
No, I never have. They look very scary. I guess it's just a lot like figure ice skating, but
that's scary enough for me.
But they have members in their league, and it was interesting here in our notes, it says the members' ages are from 5 to 67. So there ought to be an envelope somewhere there that to drop into if you wanted to play roller hockey.
And did you mention over 600 members? Did you say that, Mike?
I don't know, but 600 is a lot of
inline skates.
They have a hockey puck at their bat down the street.
That's right. It's a popular sport.
Yep. Say again? Here comes another one of those giant trucks that we talked about throughout the morning. Lancaster Roller Hockey League.
If you'd like to get some information on getting on a team, you can call 945-7719. It's the third largest roller hockey league in the western United States.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
A lot of youth and children, I guess. Children's a youth sport. Probably more so than a lot of other
Wow.
The adults really go out of their way to help the kids have something to do. What on earth is this coming up here? Now this is real
bizarre. Don't try this at home.
Yeah. Ah! They're coming down the street with their own bike ramp being towed by this little car. Maybe they'll get closer and do another bizarre set of stunts.
This might be a late entry, Mike. I don't know. We don't have any information, but as they get closer, we'll be able to tell what their shirts say. But
I think this is still part of the...
Is it part of it still?
Well, they claim
that...
Well,
they're not skating, and they're not playing hockey, so I'm not sure.
Well, let's just watch what these guys are going to do now. They're getting ready. Here comes one now, right over the top.
Look at how he's gonna ride the bike. Where? Whoa, that's nice, huh? Look at him. I think they've done this before.
Yes.
Wow. Oh, that made me nervous.
Some great camera work too by our guys shooting all the different angles. I think one of those bicycles may have gone under with the head of one of our
Dallas once teams. Again in his full armor. How many hours a day do you think these kids do this? Not just kids, kids, some adults I can tell out there to get that good.
I don't know, probably more than they actually should. I imagine they probably ought to be doing homework.
Well,
something.
They could be doing worse things, though, I suppose,
I guess,
so that's okay.
And the rumbling you hear, of course, is the movable ramp moving on down the street. That was a great entry.
That was great.
What a neat idea. Here's the Mojave High School Band. They don't have any ramps, but they have trumpets.
And reeds.
Yes.
They did their reed check at the appropriate time. Whoa. And hopefully they'll strike up the band and play us a Christmas tune. There's the roll-off.
I wouldn't bring that up too much. I don't think, I'm not sure that I...
I think that's it.
Yeah. Okay, what's the name of the tune?
This is the season to be jolly. Why didn't we get any of those hats, Mike? We could have used those today. Little Santa hat.
We just didn't buy the Santa hat off.
Well, you're under budget, right? Just like everyone else.
Deck the Hall. Not tis the season.
Oh, it was? Are you sure?
Yes. I'm not sure of anything. Here, this is a neat ride. Lancaster Old Town Site.
That's a holiday trolley joining us for this 1995 parade.
Gives us an opportunity to thank them for providing us with electricity.
Yeah, they're always good about that, letting us use all their facilities.
Someone had to come down here very early in the morning and open up the doors and allow us to plug our equipment in. That's cool. We appreciate that, guys and girls. Sunshine Generation.
This club for kids is sponsored by the Parks and Recreation Department here in Lancaster.
Parks and Rec, they call it. Busy organization. They have a lot of stuff going for kids. If you want to find out more about it, you can call. Are you ready? 947-7649. Go get a piece of paper and a pencil and write this down. Call Parks and Rec. Princess Myra Cosio, I think, or Cosio, and Princess Myra Serrano.
Wishing everyone a happy holiday season.
Yeah.
Mike, we have a lot of people to thank during this parade, and some thanks should go out to the Sheriff's Department for assisting with the parade. They always do a great job. And of course, many thanks to the City of Lancaster for their cooperation to make this parade once again successful.
We are watching movement and music. It's a dance group with 17,400 dancers sitting on the little...
Did you count them?
Little cart. Yep, there's a lot of little kids there.
AV Dance Studio 81. This entry consists of a float followed by a group of dancers in formation. We'll see them in just a second.
You know, people who come up to the Antelope Valley from out of town probably notice that most of the people in this valley walk with a certain kind of step and a certain kind of verve to them. It's because they all have gone to a dance studio. There are 25 or 30 dance studios. Everybody in Antelope Valley has to go to a dance studio sometime in their life or they can't stay here. Or so it would seem. It's a big group. Only one of four or five big groups of dancers that have been in the parade so far this morning. What would we do without battery-powered boomboxes?
What would we do?
Everybody's got one with their own music on it. Have a... What are you looking at there? We have to thank some other people here.
That's right. We'd like to express our appreciation to Waste Management of Lancaster, Sports Radio 610, and of course, Hot 97 Radio, Desert Christian School, Lancaster Community Hospital, and 4-Star Printing and Copies for sponsoring all the parade trophies. And a thanks goes out to KMIX Radio for the use of their facilities and for all the judges who tabulated all those calculations and figured out all these contest winners. There was a sweepstakes award, the theme award, the Queen's Trophy, President's Trophy, the Judges Award, just to name a few. It'd be hard to pick.
It really would. Highland High School. The Highland High School band coming up here. And I bet you they're going to play a tune.
Under the direction of Mark Wamhoff, the drum major is Color Guard D, and Color Guard captains are April Robinson and Laura Wilson.
Then again, maybe they won't play at the tune, but they have, it gives them a chance to do drum solos. That's great. Another one of these gigantic flatbed trucks.
That's a Mack truck. That's not just any truck.
Yes, sir. That's R.L. Smith Trucking. Provided the truck.
And that's Westside 4-H Club. Here are the little elves at Santa's workshop getting the sleigh and reindeer ready for Christmas.
Now, that, I bet you that's going to end up
now
in somebody's front lawn.
Yeah, because it's got lights on the reindeer. Yeah. That's very nice.
Okay, all right, I'm back online. For a minute there, I couldn't see what was going on, but we've got KTPI Radio is coming down the parade route. Jubilee in the Country, another one of our radio stations here in the community. One, the first, actually. That's Andy Waits and his family. I bet you he's a disc jockey.
I bet you he is, playing the high desert hot country.
Got carriage, by the way, was provided by the Oklahoma Carriage Company. Thank them.
For some good hot new country, tune to 103.1 or 1340 AM KVOY.
And coming up next,
Miss Antelope Valley and Miss Antelope Valley Team USA.
Now, this is Miss Antelope Valley USA. Her name is Sarah Chapin, or Chapin. This is not the Antelope Valley Fair. This is a whole different set of beauty queens.
Kelly Callahan and Sarah Chapin.
Go ahead. It's your turn.
We need to take a quick commercial break, so stay with us. In 2 minutes, we'll be back with more of the 1995 Lancaster Holiday Parade. Please stay with us.
Tests show very few of us know our geography. Educational Insights has the answer. GeoSafari, a learning game designed for kids, but as it turns out, good for all of us.
We did it!
After all, tests also show. Fun is the best teacher.
Now available at Parent Teacher Aids, your year-round educational store.
Let's discuss for a moment the myriad virtues of satellite TV. Take its affordable price tag, for instance. The basic hardware is only about $800, and for a paltry $200 more, you can add an additional TV. Then there's installation. It'll only set you back another couple of hundred, and think about all you get. Well, nothing, of course, until you pay at least $30 a month for channel packages. And for a measly $650 more, an adapter enables you to watch different programs on different televisions. And should someone want to watch something upstairs...
Hi, Phil. I was at the Antelope Valley Mall just picking up a few things for the wish list. Tonight? Oh, it's the usual holiday fair. Sylvia, you should see Jim. He's been climbing around the house all day, hanging up the holiday lights. Yeah, we're still expecting you around 7. No, don't bring a thing. Candles might be a nice touch.
For family fashion and holiday fun, it's the Antelope Valley Mall.
Need some new furniture for the holidays? S&S Home Furnishings is stocked with fresh new merchandise, like dining rooms, living rooms, recliners, and a lot more, all discounted for the holidays. At S&S, we have many financing options, like 30 days same as cash on approved credit. Gift certificates are also available. S&S Home Furnishings also has a free in-store decorating service. We're next to B of A on Lancaster Boulevard. We're truly a discount store, but with exceptional service. S&S Home Furnishings on Lancaster Boulevard next to B of A.
We are back here at the 1995 Lancaster Holiday Parade here on Lancaster Boulevard, right downtown Lancaster, across the street from what will be the Regional Library. And
you're looking right now at the AVHS Pep Steppers, Antelope Valley High School Pep Steppers, and they just pep stepped right on by real quickly.
They're going to be tired before this one's over, I tell you. They're a group of kids that got together at Antelope Valley High School and put together their own little pep squad and marching drill team unit.
And right behind them is the Antelope Valley Board of Realtors. Antelope Valley Board of Realtors' annual Christmas Cantree Drive raises money and collects canned goods for local charities. This year, the Antelope Valley Board of Realtors will donate all the food and money to Grace Resources, who then goes on to distribute it to those in need all across the Antelope Valley.
Great. Grace Resource Center has had had some problems this year because of all of the cutting of budgets mm-hmm. and the different grant facilities. So there's a lot of community support for that organization. And they're going to get it all together just based upon everybody's help locally as opposed to the other facilities that you can get down the hill.
And that's the Antelope Valley Board of Realtors Christmas train fueled by love. The Cantry Express.
Now that's cute.
Pulling that's right along behind that little
again,
train.
I bet you that ends up in somebody's front yard too for a Christmas decoration, or at least it
maybe
should.
Maybe mine, I'm going to ask.
Yeah, that'd be good. Foothill High School. Again, this is another one of the bands that has come up today for competition and to march in our parade.
The Knights are directed by George Wavell and led by drum major Jordan Richmond and majorette Allison Wellmerling. Color guard captain is Jenny Dressler and co-captain is Jim Jones.
You just did that so good. I mean, you just pronounced those names. Did you ever go to this school?
I practiced.
I see. Oh,
another
here's
sharp looking
group. Yeah, some great uniforms. Again, this is a Scottish theme. Let's listen.
Okay, I might have messed up the last one, but that's definitely Jingle Bells.
That is.
Definitely.
It's not a doubt.
This is the Lancaster Moose Lodge, number 1926.
It's a holiday jubilee. Again, that's the theme of the parade. And then some more Santa hats. I really
like that
feel
hat
out of
with
place.
The moose on it.
Yeah.
I like that one.
That's the best one.
That's the best.
Every year, they have to think up new ways of staging this parade, and they end up using more and more streets to put the parade together because there's getting to be so many entries that they now stage both ends of 10th Street West, Lancaster Boulevard, 15th Street, and about two other side streets.
And we just were looking at Kelly Taylor, who was the Tehachapi Mountain Festival Rodeo Queen, and right behind her, these are the Boron Community Queens. Miss Boron is Tina Nunn, Junior Miss Boron is Erica Bakeman, and Little Miss Boron, Kimberly Harrell. I would like to wish everyone a very Merry Christmas and a safe and happy New Year.
Salvation Army is always one of our favorite entries into the parade. This is their emergency and disaster services van, or one of the many that they have. Salvation Army has been serving the Antelope Valley clear back to 1957. During disasters at Christmas and year-round, it's always nice to know that the Salvation Army is right there if you need them. Jim Dupratt, the 1995 Christmas chairman, and Celeste Eckley urge you to support them. They're the bell ringers.
Here's the Burbank High School, the pride of beautiful downtown Burbank. Marching Bulldog Band and Spirit Squad. And our mascot here has visions of chasing cats and decorating fire hydrants and maybe even terrorizing the mailman and the dog catcher. Imagine that, a bulldog holiday dream.
It really says that, decorating fire hydrants? It does. All right.
Do you think I would make that up? And see, they're fenced in.
That's very clever.
That is very clever.
A decorative use of duct tape.
Better than being on a leash.
I suppose. I keep saying that. I suppose. I gotta quit saying that. It's driving me nuts.
And you'll notice the little drill team girls have mouth, ears, and tails, but they're behind the bulldog, so I guess they're in a safe position there.
The Burbank High School Band has been in many of the major parades in Southern California. These kids are veterans. They are in the Hollywood Christmas Parade. They're in the Covina Parade. They're in
they
several
travel
parades.
A lot, yeah. And there's home base, probably where my husband is right now.
Scary thought.
Scary thought.
That's where Russ and I go to worship. They have a lot of neat little kids sitting on there. They all have their little home base yellow jackets on.
Right.
That's so you can see them.
Oh, and here's a great entry. The AV Arabians. Through time, the world has been honored with the fire, glory, and spirit of the Arabian horse. With infinite grace and presence, this horse is really the epitome of beauty. Antelope Valley Arabian Horse Association was formed to advance, promote, and ultimately just to enjoy this extraordinary horse. I would love to have an Arabian.
Right next to your daughter's
Harley.
Pony.
Her little Shetland?
Yeah.
Well, she's got to grow into an Arabian, I suppose.
Your neighbors are going to love you.
Okay, what do we got here? Let's see. This is Miss Eastside, Gina Hendricks, for 1995, and Junior Miss Eastside, Ashley Dunham.
Pretty dress, pretty car, pretty crown, pretty girl.
That's very, very purple.
And pretty.
For those of you watching in black and white, remember when they used to say that?
No.
I stepped right into that
you
one, didn't
sure
I?
You sure did. You set yourself right up.
Fine.
This is the Cedar Street Theater. Tell us about it, Mike.
Cedar Street Theater is one of our premier community theater groups here in the Valley. They're escorted by Mike Potter's 1931 Model A. They're promoting their season this year. The 18th season. They now have moved, of course, as everyone knows, to the Lancaster Performing Arts Center.
You can see Annie Get Your Gun and a melodrama, Adrift New York. Can't see what else they're promoting this year, but
it's on the other
side. Always a good time to go down to the Cedar Street Theater. Very talented folks down there.
Every year they get better. Now here comes some strollers. I was waiting for the stroller patrol. This is the YMCA Indian program.
The little feathers.
Yeah.
Little feather makes small in little roadster.
Cute little kid. Again, that's the way to do a parade. Get into it. Stroll on it, someone push you down the
parade
route. I tried,
but nobody would buy.
Yeah. Here's some more YMCA folks. We don't know precisely who they are, but they look like they're having a great time today.
They're the Cherokees from the Antelope Valley YMCA.
Pointing out, of course, the hazards in the road that you don't want to step in. One of the wonderful rural byproducts
of
our parade.
These are all the dads and their sons right there.
She's cutting me off.
I just cut you right off on that one, didn't I?
Yeah, we have a lot more Indians coming. Holy moly, I look down the street there and there's Indians everywhere.
Choctaws and Cheyennes and Kiowa tribe, the Kiowa tribe, the Zuni tribe.
Learning about Native Americans and having a great time, I would imagine, researching their costumes.
Do you think they handmade those?
Yep.
Yeah, they would have to, wouldn't they? Those are beautiful costumes.
I think you could probably get one of those at April's costume shop, but I bet you couldn't get 40 of them. Speaking of which, April Ray and Daisy's costume has supplied some of the costumes in the parade, as usual, for free, which we are very excited about. I think it's really nice. I think they supplied costumes for two or three of the groups that are riding, and we want to thank them.
That's right. It's a fascinating place. You've been down there many times, I'm sure.
She knows where every single...
Yes, she does. Every little boa.
Yeah.
Every little glove.
And I got lost in the first aisle.
This is the Valencia High School Band.
Boy, they sound great.
Kim Tyner's the drum major, and she heads off the Pride of the Vikings under the direction of Robert Basso. Color Guard Captains are Dana Vizupera and Nicole Mayfield. Let's take a listen.
Up next in our great expanse of parade is the Angel Tree Ministries. The Angel Tree Ministries is it's actually a program. It's part of the Prison Fellowship Ministry. 23 churches here in the Valley are involved in this. They give Christmas presents to the children whose parent is in prison. Kids know they are loved and they are forgotten. It kind of helps to upgrade the season.
hope is rekindled in the hearts of the struggling caretakers.
And that was a full-on live band that just went by. Boy, with drums and guitars and everything.
That's great.
We should have stopped. Dallas should have put his foot out.
High Desert Pony Club. Looking very equestrian today.
You see those, you know, the little black hats they have?
Uh-huh.
Those are helmets. Those are metal, so if they fall off those horses, at least the top part of their head. Yes.
Very fashionable.
Oh, yes, they're very gauche. I didn't know that. You know, but, that's part of the rules for hunters and jumpers. They have to wear those helmets. There's Colonel Patricia A. Flannery, Vice Commander of the 95th Air Base Wing out at Edwards, in her 4x4 with all the antennas and stuff. She can pick up the phone and talk to Bill Clinton, I'll bet, without even batting an eyebrow.
This is Bethel Baptist Church Youth Group.
The birth of Jesus, much more than a holiday, a lifetime jubilee.
Wishing everyone a very Merry Christmas.
Here's another one of the bands that we've seen a lot during the football season this year. A great band from Palmdale High School. Looking uniforms too. The black and the green. They had a pretty good season this year. The football team did. They're getting better every year.
And we want to remind everybody that after the parade, be sure to go down to the Antelope Valley High School and attend the halftime show competition. High schools, including Palmdale, that you just saw right there, from all around the Southland will be competing, and it's an event the whole family can enjoy. And proceeds, of course, go to the Antelope Valley High School Band.
Perhaps some of you will be seeing this after that competition is over, so make a note to see it next year.
And here's some familiar faces. Palmdale Mayor Jim Ledford and Chamber members Doe Davies and David Myers.
News of your birth is just everywhere. Of the birth of your daughter.
Not
just
my
just,
birth, my I, daughter's birth.
I was covering it. You didn't give me a chance.
Yes, hello, little Allegra. I miss you. I'll be home soon.
Do you?
She's home with her daddy for the first time by herself, and that's a little frightening
Very
thought for
scary
me.
Thought.
Very scary. Terry Zirin, that crazy kooky guy, he's in every parade.
He's that he crazy well, kooky guy. Yeah, he should. He
belongs in a parade, right, or somewhere else. We're not sure where he belongs, but
Lancaster Rotary is going in style. They've got a Continental limousine. President Keith Swords and Kathy. President-elect Mark Thompson and Cynthia. I think those are wives. I guess they are.
Yes, they are. Here's something I like. This is the Fatman's First Dance Club. It's a nonprofit organization dedicated to the enjoyment of country western dancing. They dance almost anywhere, anytime. Find there's some country music on, they're dancing.
That is such fun. Have you ever tried to do that? Just,
oh, yeah.
Line dance?
Oh, yeah. That's a lot of fun.
I tried to line dance, and before the night was over, I had gotten relatively good at it. And then the next time I tried it, I totally forgot it all.
You have to do it on a regular basis.
You really do. It's not
easy. You don't use it, you lose it.
Canyon High School is coming up. Another one of the high schools down to the south of us there in Canyon Country, or near Canyon Country.
They're under the direction of Randy Gilpin, and they are the Gold Star Brigade.
Color Guard Captains Heather Crossman and Angela Patino. And boy, this is another fine organization.
8.
I'm trying to do it together.
Left.
Listen.
Okay.
We'll do it next time. Mm-hmm. Must will be so proud.
I played the piccolo.
Did you?
In my high school marching band. I figured if you're going to be in a marching band, what's the lightest thing you can possibly carry? A piccolo and a wrist lyre.
A wrist lyre?
You know, the lyre is the thing that holds the music.
Oh, yeah.
You can have a neck lyre or a wrist lyre.
Is that what that says? Yeah.
That is. It's an exciting new club established by the children for the children of our community.
So if you're a brat, call them up and
there's
join.
There's a club. There's a club for you.
Do you still have your piccolo?
Yes, I do. I have my flute, too, but it was a little heavy. That's why I switched to the piccolo.
Here's yeah. Lancaster High School.
That's the dance team we're looking at right now. The first ever Lancaster High School dance team wishes everyone a Merry Christmas and a Happy Holiday Season.
They're led by Captain Michelle.
Picarillo.
What is it? Picarillo. Yeah, I think that's right. Co-Captain Candace Douglas and Kim Lamb is the advisor.
And all in all, there's 16 girls in that club.
Here's Miss Courtsill 95, Rita Schmidt, and little Miss Courtsill 95, Erica Ricker.
Very nicely done, Mike.
Well, thank you.
And following those little misses is the Courtsville Chamber of Commerce. President Dodi Garcia and Secretary and Past President Maureen Neese are in that Mustang car.
And as the Courtsville Chamber of Commerce quietly rolls by with their waves and smiles, we're going to take a commercial break, sell some stuff, and we'll be back
in 2 minutes. Stay with us.
Remember the day you got your first two-wheeler? Your dad running beside you, offering a lot more than just a steady hand.
Gill's Bike Shop in Lancaster since 1959 now has specials on 95 clearance models, including Cannondale, Specialized, and Trek. Gill's Bike Shop carries Elk, BT, Dyna, Schwinn, and Redline. Put your loved one's bike on layaway now and get it by Christmas. Gill's Bike Shop, Lancaster.
Bikes. They'll bring back some happy memories.
Here's the deal. Right now, Gottschalk's Expressions has the looks you want for just $39.99. Sweaters. We have twin sets, cardigans, ribbed crop tops, collars. Yeah, sweaters. Pair them with soft pajama pants or skirts. These three-piece outfits are now $39.99. And Expressions has jacket dresses, pantsuits, and skirt sets, crop jackets, and short skirts. Totally you dresses, pantsuits, and skirt sets only $39.99. Buy a second one for $29.99. What a deal. Now at Gottschalk's Expressions.
It's holiday time at Mel's Jewelers. Mel's Jewelers welcomes the gift-giving season with a beautiful collection of fine jewelry that makes holiday shopping easy and fun. Mel's Design and Repair Center can repair your jewelry or create custom sensations out of your old jewelry. Come in and apply for your Mel's Jewelers 50% off card and instantly receive 50% off on all holiday jewelry purchases. Mel's Jewelers, holiday gift-giving headquarters next to the movies at 15th Street West and Avenue J8.
Because your home is your castle, make it Castle Floor Covering.
This month at Castle Floor Covering, it's the manager special. Great quality plush carpeting for just $8.99 a square yard. Includes padding and installation. Stop by our 10,000 square foot showroom and warehouse. But remember, don't miss this deal. Plush carpeting and a choice of five colors for just $8.99 a square yard.
Because your home is your castle, make it Castle Floor Covering.
And as we come back here to the Christmas parade, we see, actually the holiday parade, we see Courtsville High School band, another one of the great high school band organizations here in the valley.
Jason Mangan is the drum major and Tara Setta is the majorette. And they're leading the Rebels today. The band is under the direction of John McQuicklin. Color guard drill team captains are Mary Beth O'Dell and Jennifer King.
Playing and cheering their team on to victory. They made it to the playoffs this year.
I hope so, don't you?
Yep.
found someone. Practice in the family room?
About like your parents when you said, I want to learn to play the violin.
Yeah, well, that was
that
my
can be
mother's
a little obnoxious
idea.
Too.
Obnoxious?
Well, when first learning.
Here's the Courtville High School band again. Or no, I'm sorry, Desert Christian High School. Writing. That's the way to be in a band.
What's your cheerleader? Wow.
Yeah. Now, Desert Christian High School has a great musical department and also a great athletic department. They have gone all the way to the championship.
And right behind them is the Desert Christian Junior High, bringing gifts of Christmas cheer. Coach Barbara White and the Desert Christian Junior High cheerleaders want to wish all of you a very Merry Christmas, of course.
Now, if you're going to talk about a Corvette, there is a Corvette. There is a classic 1954 Corvette. Dale Todd is in it. Has 150 horsepower, inline 6 engine, and a 2-speed automatic transmission. That was the first Corvette.
And that's a blue flame Corvette.
Yeah. Beautiful car.
There are the Pear Blossom Queens, Miss Pear Blossom Mindy Dutton Jr., Miss Pear Blossom Arnella Clouds, and little Miss Pear Blossom Chelsea Hastings. Mindy, Arnella, and Chelsea, of course, wish everyone
a Merry Christmas.
That's right.
And a Happy New Year. From Rialto, the Eisenhower High School Band, another great organization, a big band. This is a group that's been in our parades throughout the years. They're not new to our parades, but they are sure good. They have to get up at about 4:30 in the morning, get all their stuff together, and get down to the school, and get on the buses, and then get up here, get dressed, and get warmed up. Imagine what it's like to play a trombone at 6 o'clock in the morning.
No, I sure
when it's, can. When it's 60 degrees outside.
These are the Golden Eagles, under the direction of David Barron, led by drum major Marcus Rodriguez.
To buy your submarine, yes, something like a Polaris submarine when you need one out in the desert. I think it's a transmission company.
Got the wave runners. That's what I need. You don't tip over on those as easily as like the ones you stand up on.
No, you can
get those big enough for the whole family now. You know, instead of just 2-seaters, I think they make 3-seaters, maybe 4-seaters. I'm not sure, but they're fun.
Never been on one of those. I bet those
they're
are fun.
Great, yeah. Very easy to ride on.
Personal watercraft.
There's Runner for Assembly. George Runner is running again, this time for the state assembly.
I really didn't know George had a twin. No, because earlier he was there, and here's his twin. He's riding in the parade twice today.
I want to remind everybody that the primary election is on March 26, 1996. Put it on your calendar, get out there, and vote. Make a difference.
So we got all the way to Antelope Valley High School and ran back. We're back down to 10th Street.
Well, he is a runner. Cool. That was bad. I'm sorry, folks.
No, actually.
And this is the Courtville Cub Scout Pack 146 with the theme award.
And a great sounding horn it is.
Holiday songs are heard as the Cub Scouts practice their Christmas carols around the tree for their own jubilee, while other Cubs are having fun decorating and awaiting Santa's arrival. Again, the theme award from the Corksville Cub Scout Pack 146.
A lot of work went into the building of this one.
Yeah, that's terrific.
A lot of stuff going on there.
I like the candy cane.
All right, we're going to take another short break here. We will be back soon with more of the 1995 Holiday Parade from Lancaster. So stay with us if you would.
Friday and Saturday, pay no sales tax during Gottschalk's two-day sale. Dumas blazers only $39.99 each, including double-breasted styles and striking velvet colors.
Pay no sales tax, and with your Gottschalk's charge, make no payments till April 96. Friday and Saturday at Gottschalk's.
Pay no sales tax and save at Gottschalk's Friday and Saturday. The Aroma Bread Chef is only $99.99.
Legacy automatic electric blankets are sale priced from $49.99.
Pay no sales tax, and with your Gottschalk's charge, no payments till April 96 during Gottschalk's two-day sale.
Once upon a time, there was a prince who bought a bunch of mattresses and he still couldn't get to sleep.
I still can't sleep.
He tossed and he turned, but something was bothering him. Then he found a lump in his mattress.
There's a lump in my mattress.
He searched and he found the source of the lump. It was a sales receipt from the other mattress store. The prince had paid too much.
I should have gone to CPK.
Getting a good night's sleep is more than just buying a new mattress set. It's getting the best price, too.
CPK Sleep and Sit, 10th Street West and J4.
Hi, I'm on my way down to Smith Brothers Hobby Center. Why don't you come along and check out what Smith Brothers has? We're in kind of a hurry, so we're going to take a shortcut.
At Smith Brothers, they have a great variety of hobbies to choose from. Remote control cars, airplanes, models, trains, you name it. Fits fun and fastest at Smith Brothers Hobby Center.
Oh, what's up, Brandon?
Well, we got here in good time. You be sure to stop down at Smith Brothers as soon as possible. They can challenge your imagination, too.
Come in soon and check out all the half-price specials at Smith Brothers Hobby Centers.
And welcome back to the 1995 Lancaster Holiday Parade.
We're looking now at Moore Park High School band and cheerleaders and flag carriers and pep squads and stuff from Moore Park, California. Another long drive. We appreciate the fact that they're here.
These are the Marching Musketeers.
As in Three Musketeers.
But there's more than three we can tell today.
Yes. Look at the precision that these flag carriers are doing. That's something we haven't seen before. They turned that whole banner around and marched very, I don't know what,
precision-like.
Yeah, precision-like. Whatever it was cool.
This group is under the direction of Robert Hackett.
They're going to have their work cut out for them.
Sure.
Because the wind is starting to pick up here.
And I would venture to guess that those are pretty heavy, too.
Yeah, when they're just standing
stationary.
Do they
have them in little holsters?
Yeah.
This is Cub Scout Pack 686 from Lake Los Angeles. Tiger, Wolf, Bear, and Weebelos are all represented today.
Weebelos, huh?
Weebelos. And they are sponsored by their proud parents.
Here's Junior Miss Lancaster, 1995, Eric and Mamie, and First Princess Courtney Olson. I think that the drivers of the different parade floats are being very, very generous in that they are driving around Dallas.
Yes, they are. Looking at those beautiful cars, we need to remember to thank all the car dealers for the use of their beautiful automobiles for this parade, and we appreciate their participation year after year.
Here's Junior Miss Acton 1995, Kelly Cummins, and Little Miss Acton 95, Adri Young, I think you say that, and Natalie Shaw.
Miss Acton 1995.
There are a lot of different
queens.
There's junior queens and youth queens, and I'm trying to keep it straight here. Steppers, drill team, and drum squad. Now they carry their drum corps in the back of a truck, which is very convenient. That way they can march forever if they need to.
Right.
Plus they have more drums.
Most of their drums.
Yeah, well they have stereo drums. Stereo in front
right.
And in the back.
Lancaster Unique High Steppers, and there's Miss Lancaster right behind them. Deandra Andrews, she's riding in a white convertible 1993 Corvette, sponsored by New Wave Salon and All Seasons Roofing. She has that wave down, doesn't she?
Yeah, she really
does.
Where
do you learn that? Where do you learn that Little Miss Queen parade wave?
I don't know. Probably
at Queen,
school.
At Little Miss School.
Little Miss Queen School. Here comes a, this is great.
Cute.
This is the Mothers of Preschoolers.
MOPS.
A proud organization, all of whom deserve medals.
This is a group of mothers who meet two times a month for a time of fellowship and meeting new friends. They make crafts and they learn how to raise their children from a biblical perspective. And child care is provided for children from 0 to 5 years.
The Moppets. And once again, the little kids get to ride down the parade route. Kind of neat.
I think the mothers should get to ride, too. Somebody should push the mothers. They deserve it.
Oh, listen to this. How long has this been? What, two weeks now?
2 weeks and 4 days. But I'm quickly learning.
Another one of our radio stations, good friends of ours at Jones Intercable, KVL, AM Sports, Radio 610, and FM Hot 97. Hello, my name is Rob Deshay, the sign says. He's reminding himself. That still is the biggest boom box in the Antelope Valley. I don't care what you say. Don't kid yourself. There are speakers inside there, and they're big.
Hot 97.
There's more. There's sports radio all day and all night. The Red LSC. Had a lot of fun with those guys during the course of the football season. They were doing simulcasts with us. Kevin sitting up there doing spotting, statistics, sideline action. Great guys. And girls. There's probably girls involved too.
Probably.
Guys and girls.
Probably. You know, Mike, we've got another float coming up in a moment, a band, I should say. But in the meantime, let's thank High Desert Medical Group for all the work they put in on this, all the volunteers that made this parade possible.
Yeah, they are
parents
the primary sponsor.
Yeah, they
are. They're really working hard.
You know, and Barbara Merritt, we should say a special thanks to her.
Yes, she'll
she
be...
She is the most organized woman, I'm convinced, in the Antelope Valley, the way she puts together this parade.
She'll be leaving for the institution later today.
Right after this. Right after the band competition. Barbara's great, though. She does a lot of hard work putting this together, and all the people at High Desert Medical Group.
It's an amazing task because, as we said at the top of the program, 156 entries, and that's not counting the A's and the B's and some of the late arrivals and some of the late cancellations. It's an amazing feat get this all together and get it marching in one direction. And pretty much on time, they stepped off right at 10 o'clock.
I think this is the second year they've done this, isn't it? High Desert has taken over this parade as far as organizing it. They've done a bang-up job.
Coming here soon, down the street a little ways, but we can still see the Lobos. That's Little Rock, I believe. Little Rock High School. Now, this is a relatively new school, and they have really gotten their band act, if you will, together. They've got a great organization.
Their drum major is William Dempster and majorette Francine DeCloyt. They're leading the band this morning. They're under the direction of Mr. Richard M. Perales.
Color Guard Captain Rosemarie Happersett.
It's a happy name.
It is a happy
Happersett.
Name.
And they're going to play for us, so
let's listen.
That great music is Little Miss Roseman.
Yes, what more queen.
Between the skaters and the queens and the soccer players, that's a parade right there.
That's right. You see Jennifer Roberts, Little Miss Roseman, and Leilana Boyd, Junior Miss Roseman. Wishing everyone happy holiday season.
And right behind them is Miss Mojave for 1995. Deviri, is that what you, Deviri Ayler, or Aller.
She's riding in her grandparents' 1957 Model T, and she's driven by her mother, Debbie Aller.
Now, wait a minute. Hold the phone. That's not a Model T. Even I know that. That was a Thunderbird.
You know what? You're right.
I don't know where the Model T came from.
Oh, I should have looked up on that one. There's Billy Pricer for Assembly, running for Assembly.
He's been on the Antelope Valley High School board for a couple of years. Now he's riding in the parade. Courage to fight, conviction to win. Campaign theme. It's campaign season.
And March 26th, I'm pretty sure it's March 26th. Yes, 1996 is the primary election, so get out and vote. Are you registered, Mike?
Yes, I am. Not to vote, but I am registered.
You have your papers.
1995 California City Queens, Junior Miss Melanie Helton and Little Miss Christy, I think it is, Hobson.
And there's Monica Calzadillas, Little Miss Palmdale, 1995.
Good job.
Isn't she cute?
She really is.
I want to dress like that for Allegra.
Oh, you'll be buying lots of those dresses like that. I hear some more Christmas music coming.
That's the Roland High School Band, the Raiders, directed by Dr. George Gullett. Raiders are led by drum majors Joanna Fellows and Jeremy Yang. Color guard captains are Amanda Burns and Nancy Zaho.
It's a great school and a great band. Up here for competition, I'm sure, and also because they just need
Live
to be.
Parade.
They need to be in our parade. It's an important parade.
And there's Senator Phil Wyman and family. Running for senator, I should say, 1996.
He's been a representative of our communities in different ways over the years. He's a familiar face in the Antelope Valley. Little Miss Eastside.
Monica Amaro.
Perhaps not quite as familiar, but very attractive.
She soon will be, I'm sure.
Riding on the back of that gorgeous Pontiac Firebird, provided by Rally Chevrolet, Pontiac, Cadillac.
And there's Miss Sun Village, Brandy Isham, right behind her.
Boy, we got queens today. Here's Little Miss Lake Los Angeles, Jennifer Nettle, and Amanda. You want to try that? Amanda. Hi, Amanda.
She went fast, passed too fast. And there's Ronald McDonald, somebody we all know and love. Ronald shows up at all of these parades. Little Rock 1995 is Danielle Marie Jinda. Danielle is 8 years old and in the fourth grade at Daisy Gibson School, and she loves to read, play with her friends, and help her community. That's probably why she's a little miss.
Yeah. Now here are the Lake Los Angeles Layettes. It's a drill team. Special person, did you see they have a special parade entry number carrier?
They're organized.
Yes.
Again, Mike, we want to thank the Sheriff's Department for assisting with the parade, and of course many thanks to the City of Lancaster for their cooperation to make this parade successful, as it always is.
A lot of work, a lot of pre-production, if you will, goes into these parades, traffic control. And
I tell you, they're doing their job because they about wouldn't let me come through today. They do a fine job.
This is still the Vista Lake Los Angeles Layette. Getting a nice round of applause from the people.
You're a music man. Is it the band? What do you like the best?
I think the bands would have to be right in there, or the little tiny kids,
yeah.
The little munchkin kids.
Yeah.
They crack me up. And here's one of those little munchkin kids I was talking about, Little Miss Antelope Bakers.
This is Lacey Louise Padul, and Lacey's wish for the world is for everyone to have a very Merry Christmas and to be happy always.
And to keep her hair out of her eyes. Wishing the world a holiday jubilee. Here's the Antelope Valley Sea Cadets. Of course, they're stationed there at the harbor in Palmdale.
The United States Naval Sea Cadets is a nonprofit youth program for young people. Training support comes from the United States Navy and Coast Guard, as well as dedicated adult volunteers. The ABC cadets drill every second and fourth Tuesday of the month, and on some weekends as well. a nice sport there in Palmdale.
Yes, it is. It's great.
Have you been to the restaurant there?
Yes.
Great seafood.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Extra large jumbo shrimp.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we stretched that one about as far as we could, I guess. Lancaster's second princess. Junior Miss Lancaster and second princess. I'm just no good with the...
This is Ashley Nicole Grotefin. And she's being driven by her father, Michael. Also in the car is her mother, Valerie. And Junior Miss Lancaster, 1994, Megan Downs and Becky Matigue.
Happy youngsters, having a great time. And, you know, it's a great event, these parades for the young people. They get a chance to get in these cars and on these floats and just have a great time.
Now, here's some place that you frequent very often. Dimples Family Fun Center.
Dimples is cool.
It is a great place. I like it even. Have you taken Zach there lately?
I got the nerve up a few weeks ago, yeah.
He loves it, doesn't he?
Yeah, he did. Left him there a week, I think. 10 days.
He didn't miss you a bit, I bet. It's Rhino Hockey, AV Hockey Association. The Rhino Roller Hockey Organization, they're from ages 4 to 7. Those are the Mites. The Squirts are from 8 to 10, and the Juniors ages 11 to 13.
Sierra, go ahead.
Sierra Automotive donated trucks for all the little ones to ride on today.
I was just going to say, see the way they are all sitting there on the hay bale. Someone had to stand out from the truck and organize them so they all look perfectly proportioned and set upright. That's art direction, you
that
see.
That is.
I don't know what that is. That is a rhino, I guess, huh?
That's the rhino from Rhino Hockey.
Okay. Rhino on a golf cart.
What's a parade without one?
There I go again.
And there's Gene Inlow. Gene is driving a 1952 Ford pickup truck, and he's won, get this, Mike, 56 awards over the last 8 years for his truck.
That's a gorgeous truck.
It is a gorgeous truck.
I learned to drive in a truck like that. My grandpa had a truck like that. That's how I... Well,
I learned to drive in a three-speed truck that you had to pump the clutch, pump the brakes. This is Gene's third parade here, and he's won awards in the last two parades.
Common cause of concerns we're seeing their float. Actually, their car, but it's sort of a junior float, I guess.
Yeah, a float wannabe.
This is El Toro, I believe, right?
That's right, the high school band.
High school. Again, these folks came from a long distance. I bet this has got to be the distance.
Is this the distance winner?
Yeah.
Lancaster Holiday Parade, other than
Mr. and Mrs. Santa Claus and the Elves.
Escorted by Jared Pierce. And his two Belgian draft horses, Bill and Cindy.
Gorgeous.
It's official, Mike. The holiday season's here. Santa and Mrs. Claus made their appearance.
They've moved into residence, and now the Antelope Valley will just spring with holiday good wishes all throughout the area.
And here are the directors and ambassadors laying on their bed. They're worn out.
Once again, we want to thank High Desert Medical Group, the City of Lancaster, the Lancaster Chamber of Commerce, Jones
Intercable,
everybody who helped put this parade together. Our intrepid crew that were out here at, 8 o'clock, 7:30 in the morning,
all
getting
right.
Everything set up. It's been a great afternoon.
It's been beautiful. It's been wonderful. And happy holidays to
yes,
you.
Yes, to you too. Come back on the show. We'll miss
I
you.
Will. I'll be there soon.
Okay.
Happy holidays. Merry Christmas to everyone.
Here
Irregular heartbeats, or a racing heart, often result in significant restrictions to an otherwise normal lifestyle. In the past, treatment for these conditions involved either lifelong therapy with drugs or open-heart surgery. Recent advances now offer a cure without the need for surgery to many patients with irregular heart rhythms. If you suffer from irregular heart rhythms, contact your doctor or give us a call at Lancaster Community Hospital. We're setting the standards of tomorrow, today. Start the season right with a holiday gift from Metro Floors. Now is the time to carpet your home for the holidays, and Metro Floors is giving you a chance to win a house full of carpet. What a great way to end the year. Plus, come in today for a free doormat to welcome holiday guests. Take advantage of Metro's holiday sale, like Spellbound carpet for just $7.95 a square yard, or Everlast quality carpet for just $8.95 a square yard. Hurry, this sale, like the season, ends soon. Metro Floors holiday sale going on now. Metro Floors J5 in Yucca in Lancaster.
With a 282 horsepower V8 engine, it's designed to get you there quickly. Although, once inside, you may not consider that a benefit. Presenting the BMW of luxury cars.
Hi, Phil. I was at the Antelope Valley Mall just picking up a few things for the wish list. Tonight, how was the usual holiday fair? Sylvia, you should see Jim. He's been climbing around the house all day hanging up the holiday lights. Yeah, we're still expecting you around 7. No, don't bring a thing. Candles might be a nice touch.
With our convenient extended holiday hours and more than 125 specialty shops, the Antelope Valley Mall is the perfect place to satisfy everyone's wish list.